Mick Foley, I never gave you permission to put yourself in this match. You're not a legal participant in this match. So therefore, you have forced me to do my job and reverse the decision of this match. The winners of this match happen to be David Otunga, Mark Henry, and Dolph Ziggler.
What's the matter? You didn't like that? I'm Mr. Laurinaitis. Do you find me to be disrespectful? You don't like it when I just grab things out of your hand, do you? Well, let me tell you what you're going to do about it. Absolutely nothing. Oh, you know what? Mick has nothing to do with what's going on right here. It's time we put our card. No, shut your mouth. You're going to listen to me. You're gonna man up. You're gonna take your balls out of your purse right now. We're gonna lay our cards on the table. You don't like me, but it has nothing to do with who I am. And if I could be your psychologist for a moment, it has everything to do with who you are not. See, the people have no idea who you are. That's because when you were a competitor in sports entertainment, as you like to call it, you had the look. But oh boy, did you ever suck. And that must have been really, really difficult, Johnny. Your brother being one half of the legendary Road Warriors, and you never amounting to much more than roadkill. See, you were boring, you weren't charismatic, you were vanilla. That's right, boring. And it kills you that you never made it to this stage, the WWE, as a competitor. So you traded in your lame-ass tights for your equally lame-ass suit. You went from somebody who just sucked to somebody who just sucked up. And now that you're your corporate yes man, you take your eyes and you look at a guy like me and you can't stand the fact that the last year of my career, I've achieved more than you have in your entire life. You know what? I don't even know why I'm screaming. You just don't have an original thought in your body. I mean, and you're gonna screw me at the Royal Rumble pay-per-view? Well, better men have tried and better men have failed. But you're gonna try to screw me based on one thing. It's your pure jealousy of who I am and where I come from. And the fact that I am the WWE champion, I'm the man. And you can't stand it. So you're gonna screw me at the Royal Rumble. Let me tell you something, Johnny. Doesn't matter what you do to me in my championship match, because coming out of it, I'll still be better than you. And I'll have all these people doing something that you wished your entire career they did. I'll have them talking about you. You see, because if you screw me, I'm not going to hit you with the GTS. I'm not going to put you to sleep. I'm not going to lock you in the Anaconda vice. But I'm going to have these people talking about you for sure. Because if you screw me, they're going to be talking about how Mr. John Laurinaitis, Executive Vice President of Talent Relations and Interim Raw General Manager, looks like he went through a meat grinder because CM Punk just kicked his pathetic ass. You're pathetic.
I am not pathetic. And I will not be intimidated by CM Punk.
Admit it. Just admit it, Johnny. Have the decency to admit that you intend to screw Punk at the Royal Rumble. You know, you walk around here, you act like a pious, self-righteous sycophant.
which is fancy New York Times bestseller speak for saying you, John Laurinaitis, are a kiss ass.
Foley? Who in the hell do you think you're talking to? You want to know if I'm going to screw CM Punk?
I want to know!
You're damn right I will! Okay? I do my job and I do it well. I am sick and tired of being disrespected. Okay? I'm sick and tired of being pushed around. And I'm sick and tired of being bullied. Each and every week, I put on the most entertaining show for the WWE Universe. And I'm not appreciated for it. I'm not going to take it anymore. And I'm not going to take it from you.
All right, good, you're
I'm sick and tired.
I'm old!